background begins in the 1950s. At the start of the nuclear age, atomic tests sent shock waves through society and flashes of light far out into space. These were signs of a technological society on Earth coming into its own. They were also noticed by alien visitors that had been watching Earth for thousands of years. Their first attempt to make contact failed. It was caught by a security camera in a high school gym in Danville, New York. Earth Commission responded in 1977 by sending out pictures and sound recordings aboard the Voyager spacecraft. The visitors responded by sending a signal that was picked up by an amateur radio operator. By causing Saturn's rings to vibrate in just the right way, visitors played back a recording that had been secretly placed on Voyager 1. Advanced telescope images now show alien starships massing around the planet Saturn. So that negotiations with visitors could proceed in an orderly fashion, Commission began campaign to distract the public with a series of well-formulated conspiracy theories. It released thousands of photos of astronauts on the moon. But careless errors were made in the rush to make these photos public, including images of flags waving in the absence of a lunar atmosphere, or the lack of stars in the dark lunar skies. Commission responded to skepticism by leaking pictures of sophisticated alien moon bases. Surveys show widespread public acceptance. These were done with state-of-the-art Commission Mac 2 computers. Commission followed with Y2K, the asteroid scare. Then inaugurated federal funding for tracking and publicizing possible impacts. With rendezvous scheduled for 2012, members of the public have noticed some unusual events in the solar system, like these unidentified objects in the orbit of Mars. This extremely sophisticated animation shows what they saw: an advanced 480 QVC long-distance spacecraft embedded within an asteroid. From Area 51 office, Commission planners have laid out the events that will unfold in 2012. Commission scientists have begun to release evidence that a planet X, widely known as Nibiru, will approach Earth from the South Pole on December 21, 2012. Exclusive pictures will be offered to Sarah Palin and Fox News to maximize exposure to Tea Party vast right-wing conspiracy. With the Earth in panic mode, Commission will launch a spacecraft to lunar orbit. There it will rendezvous with visiting spacecraft and transfer the cargo requested by visitors. Cargo is now being made in extremely confidential operations. With visitor assistance, scientists are creating artificial microscopic space-time anomalies, miniature black holes. Public release could lead to some big misunderstandings. With magnetic fields used to contain them, the tiny black holes will be transferred to the waiting starship. These are potent energy sources that could aid in the peaceful colonization and exploitation of resources in every corner of the galaxy. To many Earthlings, the mere presence of alien ships is a science fiction scenario. But these visitors are gentle creatures with nothing to gain from attacking Earth. They wish only peaceful technology and cultural exchanges. and to ensure Earth's peaceful cooperation in Code 4024 planning for domination of galaxy. Report prepared by Michelle N. Approval pending from Joint Commission on 2012.
That's all, folks.